and Gentlemen, willkommen bei Knus TV. Ich freue mich wahnsinnig, hier drei sehr charmante Jungs aus Boston hier zu haben. Wir haben hier den Sänger, das ist Chad. Dann haben wir hier Pete.
Hello.
Und Brad.
Hello.
Steady on that trigger's time. Walk away, counting backwards from nine. Holding his breath so the start is on nine. Time, time, sir. To the ones that left you here.
Compared to your previous sessions, how did it feel to record an album again after more than a decade? So the studio work, that you know, going into the studio, knowing that would come out something new for, yeah, long time.
We were just waiting for technology to catch up with us.
Ah.
Yeah.
That wasn't.
In 99, we felt so limited. So it was like, till they get their game together, boys, I say we're out. So we dug straight down. I can't tell you where we dug, but we dug straight down.
Making the record was a very cool experience. We recorded in a beautiful studio in upstate New York. And but to get ready for the recording, we hung out one night in my apartment. I live in New York City. And we had an acoustic guitar with us. And each guy just passed the guitar around and we played songs to each other. And I think that we knew all of us, like, hey, you know, we've got some songs here. This is for real. So we went off and recorded those songs.
So it's fun now to, like, yeah, look at a batch of songs and work with a great producer, this guy Peter Kadis, pick a beautiful studio, and yeah, it was really fun to get to choose how and when to do it.
One question, three answers, one sentence each. What does this album mean for you personally? For you, Chad?
I think it's just for me, I think it breathes life into this band. Like, we're still on our mission.
Yeah.
You know, for a while, although it was really fun to get back together for Zimbabwe and for the last show in Boston. It felt like we were visiting something in the past, and this is just feels so good to know that we still enjoy, as friends, that we still enjoy making music together.
Yeah.
Back with my brothers in a rocket ship. Going for it. Exclamation point.
Yeah. This album is like, you know, the golden ticket with Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. You know, like when he gets the golden ticket. That's how it feels to me, that I got the golden ticket.
There's a song called Bang Bang. We want to hear you sing. Yeah. Yeah, put your hands together. Come on.
All the blood to my head, got so dizzy, fell back. took my bed, I went over to the west side, looking for the hot tide. Where will I find, will I find, will I find, find? All I saw was a man that had a head that had a pump on. We've been there for years. Can someone tell me how long? Wake up to tell me. Wake up to show me what I could not find. Wake up to tell me.
Come on, wake up.
Wake up to show me what I could not. You see, this woman woke me up about a quarter to three. And I didn't know what them but she put a spell on me. Said I had to go down to where the cliffs meet the sea. Meet an old man to present my plea. So I hit it way down to the big pier. Threw away that come from my big fear. I wheeled around behind to my blind side. I found an old man with a lime and a kinda. I said, mister, mister, would you be so long? Won't you be a saint? Tell me just where I'm going. He pointed to a conch shell and into the lungs. And this is all I really need to get by. Wake up to tell me. Wake up to show me what I could not find. Wake up to tell me. Wake up to show me what I could not. Said, hey, hey, Mr. Man, I don't know who you think I am, but I can safely say that I should have been sleeping, been sleeping, been sleeping, been sleeping the day away. Hey, hey.
The album is called Circles Around the Sun, and the main song also called Circles Around the Sun. Whose story are you telling in this song? And what is the connection to the video?
We are telling the story of my friend Larry Perry, who died last year. And he was around 12 or 13 in the 1960s during the space race between the US and Russia. And he was taken from his family and sent up into space to do an orbit so they could check his vital signs. But he was used particularly because he was so disabled. He couldn't speak or walk. Well, it's a legend, and you can't find any information about it. But that, you know, the U.S. government can be very secretive, so we don't know.
Many governments.
So we don't know. His uncle told it to me at his funeral service. He told me this, like, this family secret. And but Larry was an adrenaline junkie. Like, he loved doing crazy things. So for him, it was like his biggest dream coming true. So that's why when he splashed down into the Atlantic Ocean. At the end, they opened up the hatch, and he was smiling like he just had the biggest, most wonderful trip of his life. That was in the 60s, and he died last year.
Right.
And they never thought, he was so disabled and so tightly wound like this, they never thought he'd live past his 30s. And he lived to be 64.
And he weighed about, he probably weighed 60 pounds, something like that.
Yeah.
And at the end of our, we have a music video for it. At the end of the video, you can see Chad up on stage during a Dispatch concert dancing with Larry in his arms.
That's what, this was Larry.
Yeah, that's Larry.
This was a beautiful scene.
Yeah, and he's like 50 years old in that scene. And when we did the video with Pete's brothers, who directed the video, we went to the New Mexico, to that where all the radars are, because the radars have kind of been like a Dispatch logo over the years.
What's your advice for upcoming young bands who are not signed by a major label and also don't want to be under their control?
They need to play. Anywhere, anytime, for anyone. They need to be led by their hearts to know when to play and when not to. They need to write songs from their hearts, not writing songs to an audience. As soon as you start to write for an audience, you lose everything. You lose who you are, and you lose the connection with who was coming to learn about who they are through you.
Yeah.
So that's the beginning of the recipe.
I guess keep your friendships intact with your bandmates. And like Brad said, know when to step away. It's been helpful for us.
Dear musicians, now you know how to do it. I think how to do it well. Just play. And I'm very glad and proud to have that nice guys with me. Schön, dass ihr da wart. Das war Knust TV und freut euch an diesem tollen Konzert. The elevator's got you rising so high, 17 floors, you want so much more. The elevator's got you rising so high, 17 floors, you want so much more. There's lightning on the ceiling. Coming from the corner of her eye. Yeah, there's lightning on the ceiling. Coming from the corner of her eye. Somewhere horses flee from thunder.